Don't worry about it. Yes, Julian Nipponitis. and for I'm actually thinking it could look cool if we gave the fleshy part here very light coloration, very light pinkish. And maybe some darker parts. That looks like crap. Some spots, some little ones. Okay. Particles into the water, and we are done. Which means you guys can go ahead again and post your favorite invertebrates. Yeah, he would make a fitting elder god indeed. Oh wait, I already forgot. We wanted to do that back swimming trilobite. Although we could also do something land based first. Habelia. Oh, that guy. I think the initial reconstruction was done by Daniele Defoe. Coturnocystis. Ah, yes. Yes, this extremely weird one where nobody really, at least to my knowledge, nobody really knows how to make sense of it. Looks so weird. Let me have a look on Wikipedia. Oh yeah, right. It's an echinoderm. From the Ordovician. Food shaped body, thin rod shaped appendages. Stem. Yeah, it's completely unknown how this animal lived. Very, very weird. I've seen reconstructions, I think, where it's swimming free in the water column, but I think that's unlikely. And here it's on the ground. You wouldn't really think this is an animal at first. Up. Yeah. Let's see what we can do. But that would be nice because then we have three major groups of invertebrates: echinoderms, cephalopods, and insects. Maybe we should do a land-based crustacean next. After this one. For now we do Coturnocystis. Oh ha. And when you are now like, what the hell is this? Then you're completely right. And on this side where openings I remember. Yep, it is very alien looking. It's actually more alien looking than most aliens. Even more alien looking than most of my aliens. Which reminds me to work more on the alienness of my aliens. Okay, and now is it scales or whatever they are. By the way, the way I draw the scales here now is basically the same technique I used on most larger animals as well. I just place closely packed dots. You know, when you do this right, you get a nice scale pattern. But it takes a lot of time. That's why I usually don't do it over the whole body, but just in regions where it is necessary. And in other spaces, I just suggest that it looks like that. Otherwise, you become scale blind after some time. Nobody wants it. Nobody. I think I could do similar creatures on Sylvanus, derived from relatives of my vertebrates there. Ah, yes, Tully Monstrum is problematic. I mean, we know it so well by now, but what it is, really is. Hard to tell. Okay, shading done. Please guys let me know what color you would like to see on this guy. Dark purple. Bigfoot was an alien too. Bigfoot was. Oh god. Lover stage or something else. I doubt that. Because if it would be a ontogenetic stage of something, we would probably by now find something in between, so something subadult, instead just juveniles. Although it is of course possible that juveniles and adults lived in different environments, but still seems rather unlikely to me. Jet black with white speckling. Yeah, it is like a deformed pillow with a tail. Pillow from hell. Dark purple with yellow. Ah, let's do that. Looks like candy now. Candy from hell. I actually think that's a great name. Candy from hell for this animal. Fits it perfectly. And now some highlights again. Makes the background a little bit different. Other than that, I'm finished, and you can go ahead and suggest the next one. Maybe something not marine now. Couture. No, justice. Yep. on near shore rocks. Yeah, that's rather unlikely. Ateracopus. Spider, not really a spider, but something in that direction with a tail. those pterosaur parasites. Ah, I know what you mean. I also don't know the name, but yeah. I think you can find it when you Google pterosaur parasite. I think we will do Ateracopus. That's pretty cool. Oh yes. After Ateracopus, we have to do what was its name? Gigantomurcus? Something like that. Only known from Delong, to my knowledge, there were no terrestrial trilobites. Ah, not Giganto. Oh, Titanomyrma. That's the name, yes. Okay, what could Atercopus do? Eaten a Tarvinius carcass. oh, it's from the Jurassic. I didn't even remember. Oh, yeah. Julian, it's from the Devonian. Atercopus. Not the end. The end we do after this one. Okay. I'm just looking on Wikipedia, so it wouldn't produce webs or nets. Maybe use its silk, because there are apparently silk glands preserved, to maybe wrap its eggs. Ah, okay, or lay drag lines or construct burrow walls, okay. He said infinity was nope. Back to pictures.